And last but certainly not least, our final 2021 Lee Pitts Live Person of the Year Award for Small Business Award, Mr. Ty Belford.
Ty Belford. No particular order, Ty. No particular order. My man. Ty, have a seat, man. I can see you over there just absorbing all these human stories.
Absolutely.
That's just who you are. You're a people person, right? Talk about that.
Yeah, I'm a people person. It's funny, one of my favorite sayings is, it's okay to be a copycat if you copy the right cat. That's right. So, yeah, I do a lot of watching and emulating and learning and observing. So I'm sure you put me at the end for a reason, because it was entertaining and informative and inspirational. And so, yeah, thank you.
No, actually, I did not put in any order.
Well, God did it then.
My wife, my beautiful wife, who's not here, she can't come in crowds right now, but she just typed up a list.
Yeah, it worked out.
And it worked out, because luckily we had Ty on the end, because Ty would just sit up there and soak up the human experience without being in a hurry. And his beautiful wife, Pam, raise your hand, Pam. The whole Belford crew over there, raise your hand. I want you guys to know that after we're finished here with Ty, we'll be wrapping things up, but I prefer you to just get a takeout back there and take all the food. I'm just not used to no leftovers. Let's eat all the food, folks. It costs money. Also, if you can, make your way back there and get some photos done. And we'll be mingling around here for a while before we get our great senator up here. We have some music playing. Ty is like a little brother to me. Lee Pitts Live Person of the Year Award to Ty Belford, 2021, for small business. Listen to this. As the founder of the highly successful Four Corners Creative LLC, you represent the true American pioneering spirit. Let me make sure I get this right, because we're on TV. Y'all have no idea. I know I make this look easy, but there's a lot of concentration going on up here. Take that to heart. I want to get this right. That's why I look around and somebody's talking, it just breaks up everything. I'm a nice guy, though. I'm going to start over, Ty. Ty Belford, small business. As the founder of the highly successful Four Corners Creative LLC, you represent the true American pioneer spirit by seeing the future of technology and integrating it into the overall business consultation. He does a lot of consultation to businesses around the country. You have multiplied your dynamic skill set to help other businesses around the world grow. And he resides right here in Fort Myers. Now, the concept of legacy mentality is in the minds of the entrepreneurs around the country due to your visionary leadership. We present you with this Person of the Year Award sponsored by the North Law Firm. Let's give him a hand. Now, let's learn about all those big words, Ty. First of all, legacy mentality. What does that mean?
Well, I'm glad you asked. So, I'll first say real quick, the opposite, the polar opposite of a legacy mentality would be more of a entitlement mentality. And all of us, if we want to embrace that or not, tend to have some type of entitlement type of mentality that's, I don't want to say it's innate, but we're conditioned that way, I would say, from birth, at least in our country. So the legacy mentality is basically living a life that's more concerned about your descendants. And we're not talking about the people that are born to you, but we're talking about any person that you interface in your day-to-day or your life experience. And so when we say your legacy mentality, that means that when I meet with someone maybe about a company they want to start, or maybe about a nonprofit that they want to take to the next level. I don't think about the marketing or the digital strategy. I think about the impact that they will have on the souls or the people that they're going to reach with their initiatives. Not every day did I get to work in an environment where all of what I'm talking about matters, but when I feel that I'm living within my purpose and working within my purpose, what I'm talking about matters. So again, legacy mentality is about living to create descendants, changing to the trajectory of someone's life.
And then long term.
So when you're not here anymore, you're living through whatever you created, and it's generational, and you know, just keeps going. And so I live in that every day. I'm conscious of it all day, every day, and every opportunity I have to make an impact, to change someone's trajectory, maybe for the day or for the year or for their life. My family and I, we embrace that mentality, and I try to spread it to other people as much as I can.
I mentioned Four Corners Creative and all the work that you're doing to help businesses around the world and around the United States, especially through technology and innovation and creativity. Summarize that so people can understand what Four Corners Creative does.
We're primarily a digital agency, so we do advertising anywhere from web design, social media, search engine optimization. Now with the evolution of digital television or OTT or over-the-top television, we do a lot of that as well, which is behavioral targeted. So let's say if one of the ladies in the room was out looking for red bottom shoes on somewhere, and then later today they see the banner floating up on their, you know, Facebook or Fox News, or probably not Fox News, CNN, right? So, wrong audience. So anyway, what that happens is it happens because of people like me placing those ads in the right place that resonate with the right people.
Ty, give us a success story of a business that you saw at one point that wasn't realizing its full potential, and how you consulting with that business completely turned them around. Just give that quick story.
Bunch. Can I start with a person?
You can go with a person.
Okay, I'm gonna go. So this legacy mentality is also this freedom with it. There's a lot of overlap in my businesses, and I'm gonna roll into my wife, right? So my wife is like the reason. Like, can I just say one thing real quick? So my wife and I met Lee together 18 years ago in my mom's living room. You don't know if you remember that or not. You don't know that. Okay. Anyway, the point.
In Naples.
Okay. No, in the stereo. And the truth, my wife and I did not like Lee because let me say, it's gonna be real good. It's gonna be real good. I promise you. I'm gonna pray. Let me tell you why. It's a blessing. It's a blessing. I need it. You gotta hear this. Okay, come on. I can't shut it down now. Listen. Come on. Check it out. I'm sitting on the couch and I'm living not a legacy mentality. I'm living an entitlement mentality. I'm on my mother's couch when I meet him flossing with my new girlfriend 18 years ago, my wife, right? So I'm in my mom's house, like, you know, big house, doing big things, but I don't have nothing. But I look like something. I was in that fake it till you make it mode. And Lee called it. And I hated it. I hated that he showed my wife for the moment who I really was at that moment. But the fact that he put that on me, I know now that he knew that I was more capable than what I was doing. He called me out, and it literally was a tipping point, which is one of my favorite books. People were plugging books earlier. Get the book Tipping Point. There's another one called Outliers, same writer. But he put something in me that day that made me know that I could never be put to shame in front of my wife, or she was my girlfriend at the time. Well, anyway, so the story was this. My wife was a banker for many, many years, a really good banker for a bank. She was a licensed banker. And then about a year ago, she left the bank to come help me take my company to the next level. But, you know, working together and living together, parenting together, and being husband and wife is kind of difficult. So the working together part, we decided that maybe we should let her do what she needs to do, which is pursue her goals. And we started, or she started, a mortgage company not too long ago, right? So the story, the big story, is to set her free. Like, she's probably made in the last 3 months more money than she made in the last year when she was working at the bank. But so that's my favorite story to tell her today. But I got a lot of stories. I've helped over 236 people start companies in the last 6 years.
That's what I want to get on. Give them a hand. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit to that. So one of the things that I do, and this is our last person, we'll be around. Skinny, you can get the music on as soon as possible after this, is that when I see young men, and I know that they're faking, they're not doing anything of substance, bling, bling, look at me. But I can see there's no substance there. So what Ty is saying is I let him know, bruh, get some substance with all of that. Y'all see he's got the gift of gab. And he's my little brother. I didn't know he was going to come up here and tell that story.
I had to tell it.
And then he just blossomed. Because he knew that I could see. And the reason I can see is because I work on substance. I'm in the spotlight not by design. I wasn't trying to be in the spotlight. I happened to be in the spotlight. I did not want to be on television, you guys would be surprised to know. And when I was offered a TV show, I turned it down 3 times back in the 90s. I wasn't interested in television. I was a pinstripe, blue suit, wingtip banker. And that foundation allows me to see when I see talented people like Ty faking. I know what substance looks like. I didn't tell him that in a harsh way, but maybe I didn't realize you felt it like that. And I'm so proud of you now and all the work that you're doing. And I'm glad that, I don't remember how I said it to you, but I kind of tell people in general that I don't care about your fancy cars. I don't care about your houses. I know a car depreciates when you drive off the lot. I don't care about that. I care about your human capital. What's in your brain, how you're applying it, and how you help the community. And a lot of these young, us who are professionals, we have to pull young men like this to the side. Because Ty didn't grow up in the hood. Ty was living in a big house down in Naples. I had never seen a black folk living in a big house down in Naples.
I'm from Detroit.
But he's from Detroit. He's from Detroit. But he was a little, his parents provided an opportunity for Ty. And Ty now helps a lot of other people. And that is why I'm so proud of him. And I'm glad you told that story, Ty. I was going to shut you down.
Glad you didn't shut me
down. All right. And now you substance. Substance over bling bling.
Over bling bling.
Works every time. Let's give him a hand.
Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.